Hi, hello, welcome for the Tamil Curious channel viewers, and we're going to interview today a most important person in India, and the name is called Mr. Haider Ali Syed, and he's from Mumbai, from Bandra, and he's a researcher and social activist of race and caste, and we're going to interview today. And hi sir,
Vanakkam. Right from teenage I was attracted to religion and mosque and spiritualism, and then it's like a journey, like from a teenager, it's a journey. Slowly, I gradually developed into research and all. Research and all. And then usually people used to, the Jamaat used to come and tell us to come to Jamaat and all. But I always stick to Quran. I said, if you are teaching me Quran, then only I will be able to join you.
Okay, that's your part of your research.
Yeah.
You are into researcher.
I'm into researcher.
Okay, when you get started your research,
after 10th, then gradually I went to different school of thought of Islam. And then ultimately got a chance to work with Dr. Zakir Naik.
So after 10th you started
after
your research?
After 10th, then gradually entered into business, dad business, and part time I was into research and all. And gradually after my marriage, I went into full time with Zakir Naik for 8 months. I was there during the time when in Orissa the RSS people burn some pastor, no? That time I was working with Dr. Zakir Naik.
And which things impress you that to start a research in particularly for race and casteism?
See, Quran talks about equality.
Okay.
And at the same time, there is a Hanafi fiqh which talks about Ansari as suppressed, like how Manu law is talking about. Same thing, Hanafi law is also talking about.
Okay. So you're talking about Manu laws and Hanafi law?
Hanafi law is a similar track. So it's totally like contradiction. What Quran talks about and what Hanafi law and Manu are on a similar track.
Okay. How you can talk about both are similar? Because this is completely...
See, in Manu law, Shudra are considered inferior. In Hanafi law, Ansaris are considered as inferior. There are lower caste in Muslim also, no? Upper caste, lower caste in Muslim also.
Yes, I agree that. Because... So, in Muslim also, there is a...
Caste system. They are maintaining the caste system.
The casteism is being...
Yeah, it's maintained. It's maintained.
Okay. So, because the research and which point you've been... We have to research it. Because you're talking about Manu. Also, you're talking about for Mohammedan-oriented of casteism differentiated.
Yeah.
So, how we can compare these two things? Because this is Hinduism, this is Muslim compared to Mohammedan. How we compare it to both are equal?
See, actually, when you read Quran, Quran is just a reminder of previous book.
Is the name of the previous book?
Previous book like Bible, Torah, Injil, and a book of Sanatan Dharam.
So, Bible is the front runner of Quran.
Yeah, yeah. It's a reminder. Thus, it's reminding whatever the Quran is actually Furqan. Furqan means judge, separating, correcting previous book. This is the purpose of Quran. Okay. And Prophet Muhammad completed Islam in 7th century. The Islam we started first. First is Adam. And from Adam, first is Tamil also. And if you do the first research, like Tamil is the first language, Tamil, first human being is black, and Quran chapter 15 verse 26 says the same, the first human being is black. Then Tamil is the first language, if you do the research, you will come to know. Then cradle of civilization is Tamil Nadu, Sri Lanka, Kumari Khandam. Okay.
Okay, sir, you're talking about too many information. Yeah. Let me confirm one by one. You're talking about Islam and as well talking about Quran. And first you registered that... Bible is front runner and Quran, Bible is front runner of Quran. So first book is Bible and subsequently and Quran has been taken place. And
Prophet Muhammad is the last and final messenger.
Yes, agreed.
Quran doesn't cancel the previous book. It rectifies the previous book.
It's rectified or ratified, sir?
Rectified. Matlab, whatever the interpolation is done by previous book. Like for example, if you read because the first is Tamil, and if you read Shivite system, the Koel system, Koel means house of elected minister. The same thing is applied in Quran also. Jumma system. Jumma is behind the elected minister. A get together behind the common people. Then we have a yoga and meditation. Same thing as a sabar and salat. Quran talks about Kundalini chakra, activation of Kundalini chakra. Same thing as a Shivite system only.
So you're comparing the Hindu...
Not Hindu. Hindu is not the right term. Okay. Hindu is not the right term because...
But so-called, as of now, it's so-called the people can remember Shiva and...
Shiva.
Shiva and whatever Tirumal and all these people, it comes into Hinduisms.
See, Quran chapter 42 verse 13
yes.
clearly says that Prophet Muhammad followed the religion of Noah. What religion did Noah school of thought follow? And they followed Ibrahim, Ismail, Isaac, all followed the same religion.
Okay, so to understand, very clear understanding for the viewers, Noah it is discussing in the Bible. Quran it is for Muhammadan, so-called understanding is Muhammadan. And you're talking about Shiva. Shiva it is so-called understanding in Hinduism. So three kind of the ism we are talking about, but you are connecting into one bowl because Quran, it is the rectification of the book for the Bible.
Previous book
for the, that is called the Bible.
Bible and plus the books that came between Adam and Noah.
Okay. So Noah, it is discussing in the Bible. So Adam and Noah, that is one part.
And family of Ibrahim is the second part. Okay. And if you read Bible, from after Noah, we had three more races: Ham, Sham, and Japheth.
Okay.
From Semitic race, we have Ibrahim.
Okay.
From Sham, we have the Ibrahim race.
So as per your concern, and for Adam and Noah, which textbook it talking about, sir?
It's talking about the books which Tamils have. Vedas, everything. Vedas, Puranas, Itihasas. Lots of information of Tamils has been taken over by the Aryan settlers. And they have interpolated the lots of matter that has been suppressed.
Okay.
Okay. Because see, Quran is not for Muslim.
Okay.
Islam started. Quran is a reminder for the Asivigam, Siddha way of life. And first Siddha is Shiva. And as per Quran chapter 96, 1 to 5, Adam, Allah thought by pen.
Okay.
If you ask any Tamil people, who is the first Siddha, who is the first master, he will say Tamil.
So, as per your research, Quran is Siddha system.
So, it's Asivagam, yeah. It's a reminder for Asivagam system.
Okay. The first Siddha is called Shiva, Lord Shiva.
Shiva.
Okay. So, that the concept will be derived in Asivagam.
Yeah, Asivagam.
In Asivagam, later on, it will be called as a Quran.
Yeah, it's a reminder for Asivagam. It's
okay.
A book. It's a last and final book. That book doesn't complete the law. It is completes few rules and regulation has been changed. For example, like previously there was inter-caste marriage was not allowed. Inter-caste marriage, but
in
now
Asivagam.
In Asivagam. Now okay. That Quran has rectified that old law,
okay.
And now inter-caste marriage is allowed.
So in Quran, inter-caste marriage
is allowed. It has changed the law. Caste is profession.
Profession.
Yeah.
All right. So, you know, as per the Quran, caste means profession.
Profession. Profession is allowed. Inter-caste marriage is allowed. You can marry your slave, like a labor class, you can marry you.
In the world, the very major people following Jesus Christ and as well, Christianity will be following it. And regardless of the countries and regardless of the race and sex of the people, they believe that the first person in the world is Adam and Eve.
True.
So, Adam and Eve, you're talking that Tamil is the first language. As per your research, you told me that Tamil is the first language. Adam and Eve, what is the language of Adam and Eve? So as per your research,
it's Tamil only.
It's Tamil only.
Because today, first human color,
okay.
Color is black. And Quran chapter 15 verse 26 says that first human being is black. Total Bible also refers the same.
Mm-hmm.
So first human is black. First language is, if we do research, Tamil is the first language. Cradle of civilization is Tamil Nadu, Sri Lanka, Kumarikanda. This is where the civilization started.
So, I do have one question, sir. So, being a Muslim and you believe that Tamil is the first language.
Yeah.
And you confirming that Adam and Eve language is the Tamil.
Yeah. And even God's language is Tamil.
God's language is Tamil.
Tamil, yeah.
So, how do you come to a conclusion that God's language is Tamil?
See, if you because Quran is a reminder for previous book, scriptures and revelation, and previous
okay.
scriptures are with Tamil people. And if you ask any Tamil, they will because the first generation of Adam are Tamil only, na? So they have the information, and Quran is a reminder for them.
So, as per your concept, so Quran is the reminder for the previous book, that is Asivagam.
Asivagam and
so Asivagam written in Tamil.
Tamil, yeah.
So why the Quran is written in Arabic?
Because the Prophet is in Arabic land, na?
Okay.
And plus the Quran also, because Bible is Quran also contains information of Bible also, Torah and Injil also. But that language is not Arabic. So all the information of previous book, Asivagam books and Torah and Injil is coming to Prophet Muhammad, because Prophet Muhammad is an Arabic prophet, Arab prophet. His language is Arabic, so his all the information is given in Arabic language.
So how the transformation has been taken place? Because in Tamil to Arabic, how the transformation? Because and still Tamil is in alive in the world. So since it is very because all other languages are has been formatted, all other languages are formatted. Only the Tamil has been given by the God. So still Tamil is alive. So as per your concept, Quran is the reminder book of the Asivagam. Asivagam still it is in Tamil. And why it has been transformed into Arabic?
Because the Prophet is in Arabic, no, Arab land.
Agreed, sir. Prophet is in Arab. Why it is gone into Arab?
This is a continuation. See, if you read the Tamil history is divided into four parts.
Okay.
First part is Adam.
Okay.
Adam. Adam is black. First human being is black as per science, as per Quran, as per Bible.
Okay. Where Adam lives in the world, sir?
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka.
So you are very
confirmed.
100% confirmed.
There's a Adam peak and Adam bridge over there.
So Adam rays and Adam genes and Adam DNA has been found in the Sri Lanka.
Yeah.
So the first person who have been generated in the Sri Lanka. So which means Sri Lanka, it is Tamilian land.
Yeah, Tamilian land. It's a Tamilian land.
As per the historical.
Historical. Tamil Sri Lanka, Tamil Nadu, Kumari Kandam. This is the first part of the story. And actually if you see, Cain was the first child of Adam.
For Adam.
For Adam.
Okay.
He was not the color of Adam. He was a different color. He was an Aryan race. White color.
So, how come possible, sir? Because he is a son of Adam. So, that's obviously, son can resemble the father.
See, you have to do race history. If you see the world by race, Quran gives us direction. See by color and language. So, we have different people on earth. We cannot see the faith. If you say, I am a good person, how can I trust you? But by race, I can say he's from which race? Chinese have a different DNA. Africans have the different DNA. Semitics have the different DNA. Europeans have the different DNA. And Tamils have the different DNA. So there are five races altogether. And first is Tamil DNA. Second is Aryan DNA. So the story rotates around Tamil and Aryan.
Okay. As per your concept, has been the first is Tamil DNA.
First.
And second DNA is Aryan.
Aryan DNA.
And third?
This two. The first part.
Okay, the first two, these two parts has been mainly you're taken.
Yeah, taken part.
Okay. Tamilian, as per the evidence, it is saying that Adam is the first person of Tamilian DNA.
DNA.
So that has been located in Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka, the entire land belongs to Tamilian.
Tamilian.
So nobody cannot climb those land into for any other persons.
The people who are speaking Sinhalese language over there, by DNA they are Tamil. We are fighting on the basis of language, which is divided by the foreigners. To take the land and the resources of this land of Tamil, people are dividing the people as per the language.
Okay.
See, by race, those people are Tamilian.
Okay.
They may be speaking any language. Today, people are speaking Dravidian language, but by race, they are Tamilian.
Because nowadays, the people are scientifically advanced. The people asking for evidence. Why? Because as per your concept, research and all that, you're saying that I'm by race and by DNA, I'm a Tamilian. Because since I'm a Sri Lankan, and by race, I'm a Tamilian. What is the proof for it?
See, proof, Bible and Quran, if you believe in Bible and Quran,
okay,
then you will come to know, because it's a guideline, a history book for a particular race. Christian, Protestants, Roman Catholic, Shia, Sufi, Wahhabi have no connection to holy books.
Okay. But we are connecting a particularly a race of people, and Tamilians, the land is called Sri Lanka, because in we have a lot of evidences called Tamilian land is Sri Lanka. But Sri Lankan DNA also is
Tamil alone.
As per your research concern, how do you come to a conclusion that Sri Lankan DNA also can Tamilian?
See, those people who migrated there, after the war of Kalinga, they migrated. Say 700 to 800 people, they migrated from Orissa to during Ashoka time, after the Kalinga war.
Okay. So, they are migrated from Tamilian land.
Yeah, they have migrated from Tamil.
The forefathers are Tamilians.
Tamilians. Because, see, that's why I say we have to divide Tamil history into four parts. The first part is all the pyramids across the globe are built by the Tamilians.
Pyramids.
Pyramids.
Yes.
Okay. Pyramids. They are built by Tamilians.
Okay.
So the pyramid concept is not for Egyptians. Egyptian is also a part of Tamil land previously, before the flood.
Okay, before the flood has been taken from land into water and water.
Noah period, before the time Noah flood. The history before the Noah flood belongs totally to Tamil people.
Okay.
Then after flood, we have three more races: Ham, Sham, and Japheth. From Ham, we have the African blacks. Sham, we have the Semitic blacks, which we call Ibrahim family. From Japheth, we have the Chinese Mongolian.
Okay.
Altogether, there are five races.
Okay. So as per in Tamil reference, I came to know for the three names what you have told, and up to Noah period, from Adam to Noah. So the people used to speak only Tamil language. So no other language has not been spoken afterwards. So okay. After the Noah, there is a three race will be been coming to.
But during
existence.
During the time of Noah, we had two races. One is Aryan and another is Tamil.
Okay.
So Aryans are Sanskrit language. Sanskrit is just an oral language.
Oral,
not a written form.
No, there is no any written format for as like in Tamil.
No, Sanskrit got into written form just maybe in Vedic age 4000 years BC around that time.
So Aryan languages.
Yeah.
So from so as per your research, you make it as a two. Adam to Noah,
two
we
race.
Have a two races.
Two race.
Tamil and Aryan.
Tamil and Aryan.
After Noah to as of till date, we have a three races.
Yeah.
So that is same Kam Yabeth, and that is that we call it in Bible, and you call it in Shame.
Ham, Sham, Japheth.
Ham, Sham,
Japheth.
Japheth.
Yeah.
All right. After Noah, how the Tamil land or the concept of the Sanatana Kolgai, the principle of Sanatana, so how it has been built up?
See. We have the coil system. Okay. We have to go by the principle. Like first, we have to understand that first murder took place.
First murder. Yes.
Yeah.
In the world.
In the world. Yeah. By the first son of Adam, that is Cain.
Okay.
Okay.
No.
So Cain is the father of Aryan race. He was cursed and banished from cradle of civilization. That is Tamil Nadu.
Okay. The first murder, that is the victim is Abel, and the murderer is Cain.
Yeah.
So Cain, the race has been started as the first murder.
He was cursed and banished from cradle of civilization, and that's why till today, Aryan concept has not entered into Tamil Nadu because of the curse of Cain.
Okay.
So we have to understand this. There are two races. One is Aryan race, another is Tamil race. Tamil is a highly civilized race, and Aryans are hunter-gatherer society, cave people.
Okay.
Two race.
Okay.
And Prophet Noah is a prophet for his people, like Tamil nation. That's why Kumari Khandam is Bible. These people have interpolated the Bible that it's a global flood, but it's not a global. It's a local flood. It's only for the Tamil people. And Kumari Khandam submerged. And after Kumari Khandam submerged, we had three more races. But why Kumari Khandam submerged? Because as per the Bible, if you read the Bible, they were mixing DNA. Like, but before that, we have to understand Shiva. What is Shiva?
Okay.
Shiva is the first Siddha. All the information which God has given on all subject is to Shiva.
All right. So when Shiva is coming to an existence?
He is the third son of Adam. The biblical name for Shiva is Seth.
Whether the Shiva has been appeared Adam and Noah period or after the Noah period?
He is the third son.
Third son of Adam.
Third son.
So in between
first the... son is Cain, second is Abel, third is Seth. Seth is Shiva. And Islamic term is Sheesh al-Islam. Sheesh. Yeah.
Okay. So Shiva is son of Adam. Okay. So
and he is the first
what is
Siddha.
The proof for it, sir?
See, Quran is, as I told you earlier, Quran is a reminder of previous book.
Yes.
Quran talks about teaching someone with pen.
Okay.
And as per the Tamil tradition, the first person who was thought was the Siddha of on the various subject is Shiva. And Quran also chapter 3 verse 30 talks about the succession administration and Shiva genealogy is succession like Seth. If you see Seth, if you read Bible, Seth, a royal bloodline of Seth, it goes up till Noah, and after that it goes up till Ravana.
So Noah, it is goes up to Ravana.
After Noah, it goes up to Ravana.
Okay, after Noah period, it is first Adam to Noah and Noah to Ravana.
Ravana. Chapter 3, verse 33.
Chapter 3, verse 33
of Quran. Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim.
All right. So that is there is a reference is available in Quran.
Yeah, Quran is there.
So chapter 3 and verse 33, it's discussing about
Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim.
All right. Okay. Fine. So and, we are making into the two parts. That two is parts. Adam to Noah, Noah to Ravana. So up to which there is Tamil race.
Tamil race.
So and from
previously during the time of Shiva up to Noah, the almost full earth was under the occupation of Tamil people.
Okay.
And after the flood, from Turkey to Indus Valley to Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and Southeast Asian country, Cambodia, all this highland, these people, this land was Tamil land.
So all this you're talking about for two continental area, it belongs to Tamil area.
Yeah, earlier wherever you find pyramids, it is built by Tamil race.
From each concept is Tamil race.
Tamil race. There is no alien or something. It's no Anunnaki, no alien. They are all built by Tamil people.
It's not alien, it's Tamilian.
Yeah, it's Tamilian.
Okay. So maybe they take out the T and they call it as an alien.
Alien, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine. So I do have certain question on Shiva. Shiva, the characteristics it described so far, we understanding is Shiva having the tiger skin. That's a tiger skinned person. And as well, the job of the Shiva is to kill the people.
He's also a preserver, as well as destructor.
Yes, he's a destroyer.
He's a destroyer as well as a preserver. Na?
As a preserver.
Preserver. Na?
He's the job, main job is to preserve and as well destroy. Save and destroyer. The two things, the work of Shiva.
See, but if you study Shiva, we all are Shiva. Because Shiva is nothing but a book, an information. And that information, if you want, you can preserve the earth. With that information, if you want, you can destroy the earth.
So,
we have to keep the balance.
So, as you told that who and all is ready to save the human's life or any
the preserver part of Shiva.
Organ's life is part of Shiva.
Part of Shiva.
So, you're abiding with Kamala Hassan's statement. So, you also God and me also God like that.
Everyone is God. Because what is Atma?
Atma is a soul.
It's a soul and it's a God's particle.
Okay.
Atma is nothing but God particle.
Okay.
That's why in Shivaite system, we have to activate our Kundalini chakra to active and get connected to higher conscious.
So you believe in Kundalini chakra?
Kundalini chakra. Even Quran says, na, chapter 15, verse 87.
Quran is talk about Kundalini.
Kundalini chakra.
So chapter?
15, verse 87.
Oh, all right. And what it talks about the Kundalini in Quran, sir?
After wisdom, see, we cannot. If we read book, reading book and getting wisdom is two different things.
Okay.
So wisdom comes from higher conscious.
All right.
So all the ancient siddhas, all the prophets, all the things, I went into seclusion for doing meditation. And meditation and yoga is nothing but to activate ourselves to get in connected with higher conscious, and it's possible because we have the Atma in us, and Atma is nothing but God's particle.
So, in Tamil, in ancient period in Tamil, we call it as Ogam. Ogam, it is a kind of a concept of Shiva. It is introduced for the Ogam, and now it is called as a Yoga. And this concept belongs to purely for Tamilians.
Tamilians.
So it is not belongs to the Aryan.
Aryans, they were cursed and banished because no prophet came among them. They had no prophets.
So they are cursed with people.
They are separated. They are not civilized people.
Okay.
Until today, they are not so civilized.
All right. Yes, agreed. So the completely
see the story. The story of the earth rotates around Tamil people.
Okay.
Even see if you look at Columbus, he wanted to come to India.
Okay.
To meet whom? Tamil civilization.
Tamil civilization.
To get the technology which they had. To trade with them.
But Columbus concept is not to visit Tamil people because he visit the people of civilization.
Yeah.
So the place that he visit, it is called as India.
It's India.
So but it is
the technology is with the whole black people in India are Tamil. Na? Not only the part of Tamil Nadu, but full India, Pakistan, wherever the black people are there, they are Tamilian by race.
So as per your concept, who and all black people in the world, they are
not world. There are three types of black. First black is Tamil. Second black is African blacks.
Okay.
Third is Semitic black.
Semitic
black. That's where from children of Israel have come. And Obama and all the South American blacks are Semitic black.
Semitic blacks.
Yeah.
So the Semitic blacks and Negroes and all that, the people is not comes in Tamil race.
No, they are actually Aryans and Tamils are cousin, and Ham, Sham and Japheth are children of Tamil race. That's why Asivagam concept is, we can find Shiva in among the Tamil Chinese civilization also. They have that Kundalini activation system is there. Similarly, same with applies with the Semitic as well as Hamitic.
And right from the beginning of the world and up to Veda in Tamil concept, there is two types of concept. And for Aryan, they don't have any written concept. Only for Tamilians, they do have a written concept. The written concept will be of starting with Adam to Noah. And now it has been Asivagam concept. The same Asivagam concept, it has been followed by the Quran.
Yeah, followed by a family of Ibrahim, where all the prophets came. And from family of Ibrahim, we have Prophet Muhammad.
So, if the same pattern has been followed by the Quran, and do you think that Iran, Iraq and all other majority in the Muslims countries and one who following the Quran concept, they're all Tamilians or different other race?
They are actually settlers. Settlers, because as I told you, from Turkey to Indus Valley belongs to Tamil nation. But after the invasion of Aryans and Persian Empire and Roman Empire, those land was occupied by settlers. And settlers are hiding behind the Muslim label. Shia, Sufi, Wahhabi, all this. Because see, in the 7th century, Islam got completed. Quran got completed, Islam got completed. The Islam was started from Shiva. In this Islam which the Quran talks about is talking about the first Siddha, Islam.
Okay.
The first Siddha is Shiva, and whatever the information which God gave to Shiva, that rules and regulation, minor changes has been taken place in Quran. Like for example, in the Old Testament, only 10 commandments were given to children of Israel.
Okay.
So like every period, based on their capacity, God judged whether this community will take up the law or not. Okay. So the Quran is basically just a changing of rules, little slight change in laws. Quran is a continuation. It's connected with the first Adam, Noah, family of Imran, family of Ibrahim.
Okay.
And the first is Tamil, and first Siddha is Shiva. So Shiva, whatever the Shiva got the rules and regulation, it's been followed by the completed that rules and regulation. Now no new rules will come.
Okay.
It's completed.
Okay. So as per your concept is, in 7th century, Islam got completed. The rules and regulation for the
whatever the abrogation or any deletion or addition is there has been completed.
So the regulations, its concept is in terms of how to lead the life.
And so already the life is already been given to Shiva. Every rules and regulation of mode of worship, everything has been mode how to govern the people. Everything is with Shiva. The same thing has been talked by Prophet Quran and Prophet Muhammad.
Okay.
The only few, like for example, I'll give you that inter-caste marriage. In Asivagam, it was not allowed.
Okay.
But after this, the Quran has allowed the inter-caste, you can marry your slave, like lower caste, even the labor class people, you can marry. The elites can marry the labor class.
So the complete shape of the governing the people and give birth and all that, the people morality and the principle of to live their life and all that have been completed in the 7th century. In terms
No. It's, the rules and regulation is already there with Shiva. Shiva is there, but only few rules and regulation are amended, changed little bit.
I agree. Because already the rules and regulations given by the God to Shiva.
Yeah.
Shiva is the ultimate, the ultimate person who have been narrated all the rules and regulations.
Yeah.
The narrated regulation, the written document,
government system, everything, whatever,
yes,
how to live the life. But the mode of worship is still the same. Yoga, meditation, Kundalini chakra, and standing behind the elected minister.
That completely remain be the same.
Same.
So there has been derived from the God to Shiva. Shiva has been written the document that is called the Asivagam. So that Asivagam completed in the 7th century. Thus, after the 7th century, the few amendments taken place in the 8th century. That is
not 8th century. 7th century last.
7th century
full
last.
Full stop. No amendment. 8th century, we are the people who changed the rules and regulation are the not from the Tamil race. They are from Aryan settlers.
Okay.
Like how Jesus said. Jesus said in the Bible that you cannot cancel the old law. We have to follow the old law.
Yes.
But Saint Paul says that you don't have to follow the law. Who is Saint Paul? Saint Paul is a Greek Aryan.
Yes.
Similarly, after Saint Paul never saw Jesus Christ. he cannot be an apostle because apostle means the one who is with Jesus Christ. So he is having a put himself as a own apostle. He has claimed he's an apostle, but he, as per technical term, he's not an apostle.
Yes.
Similarly, same thing happened with Prophet Muhammad. After the completion of Quran, Asivagam, then the Aryan settlers, Roman and Persian, they started interpolating the corrupting the system because they want the Varna Dharam caste system to be maintained. And Asivagam is not based on caste system, untouchability. It's like people were living in golden age before, prior to untouchable era, they were living in golden age. What was the system? Because the system at that time was that common people took an active part in administration. So ruling and the common people were equal.
Good.
Okay. The same thing applies with Prophet Muhammad also said the same thing. What is Jummah? Friday prayer. Friday prayer is behind the Khalifa, appointed minister.
Yes.
What we are doing? We are standing behind Pujari. Okay. Brahmin system.
Yes.
So nothing is there. It's just ritual is happening over there.
Okay.
But the ultimate goal is to bring peace among the society. This is what the meaning of Islam means.
Correct.
Peace. Peace between the society. We are living together. With peace between the animal kingdom, plant kingdom, space, air kingdom, animal, birds. We have to live in harmony with everyone.
All right.
So the 8th century Shia Aryans, Persian Aryan, they started Shia concept. 8th century.
Okay.
9th century Sunni concept came about.
Okay.
13th century Sufism came about. 18th century Wahhabi came about. Wahhabis are Saudi. Saudis are not real Arabs. Real Arabs are black. Those are Aryan settlers.
Okay.
Okay.
So
the means the fight is between the cousin, between two cousin system. One is Shiva, Tamil, and Aryans are cousin brothers.
Okay.
You can rectify Europe. Europe, after the First World War, Second World War, they entered into spiritualism and they rectified themselves. But since Aryan settlers, the coming of Antichrist, which the Bible talks about, and Hadith talks about coming of Dajjal, the Kali Yuga was started by the Aryan settlers.
Okay.
So we are fighting with the two cousins are fighting over the system.
Okay.
So they are basically corrupting the official, corrupting the people, corrupting, maintaining the Brahminism system.
Okay.
See, today Aryavarta, today what is happening in India, that today Arya in India and in minority. Aryavarta concept is not possible in India.
Okay.
But still that funding is coming from Saudi, a Muslim world. Because by DNA they are what? Roman Empire, Persian Empire. Quran chapter 49 verse 13 clearly says to identify by race and tribe.
Okay.
Not by religion.
Okay.
Faith is something personal to you.
Okay.
What you are, I cannot see.
Yes.
But by race, I can see whether he's Chinese, whether he's African or Semitic or European or Aryan or Tamil. So we have to identify as per tribe. This is what Quran says. We have to identify by race. So based on race history, I went into Tamil race history, Mongolian race history. This different history. What is the history of Europe? They say they are living in dark ages. Gay, lesbian, animal sex, all the anti-spiritual they are following. But after First World War, Second World War, they were rectified. But after the in contact with Wahhabism, again they went into dark ages. They are struggling.
Okay.
See, today we have the single currency in Europe.
Yes.
So people are not running after money.
Yes.
There's peace in society.
Mm.
Mafia is gone.
Mm.
But today, today in India, we are living in the state of confusion.
Mm.
There's no proper, all the Dalit movement, Periyar movement, every Dravidian movement has failed.
Mm.
And ultimately, Brahmins are still in power. How's it possible?
Okay.
They have come in power.
Okay.
So, unless we don't go back to the Shivaite system, the Koel system, and common people going into Koel and fighting for their rights, then only equality will come. Na?
So, Quran also amended in the Tamil language or in Arabic language?
No, Arabic language.
Arabic language. Why it has been changed, sir?
See, Arabic language, why? Because the Prophet is from Arab. And Quran not only talks about Tamil, it talks about Ibrahim also. The Quran... statement is there in Quran saying that the Prophet is in Arabia. His language is Arabic. We will give him a revelation in Arabic. He will understand and he will guide you.
Okay. So, as per your concept that in 7th century, Muhammad Nabi is the Prophet.
He's the Prophet.
So he's lived in 7th century.
From 630 was, I think, 632 was the last.
Okay. Yeah. So that is the last.
Yeah.
So, but also, though it is written in the Arabic, it is follower of the
continuation. Chapter 42, verse 13.
It is continuation of Lord Shiva Vasivaka concept. Yeah, yeah.
Because chapter 42, verse 13 clearly says the religion, the school of thought which Prophet Muhammad followed was what Noah followed. And Noah is from the genealogy of Shiva. As per biblical.
Okay.
And whatever Asivagam knowledge is carried is continuation. And the same religion has been followed by Ibrahim, Ismail, Isaac, Yaqub. It's written in the chapter 42, verse 13.
So, Bible and Quran and Lord Shiva, they are one and the same.
One same.
They have everything concept is
God
same.
Is one.
God is one.
God is one. And his books are all one. From one source. It's a continuation.
Okay. In the continuation of dynasty and one person, Aryan, it is the cursed people. Yeah. They are not civilized so far. So they wanted to be civilized once again. So they are building the concept of Sana. So far they are building the concept of Sana, so they're dividing the people of Varnasaram Dharmam.
Yeah.
And for that they're dividing people into the Sudras and Shias and all that. All the concept will be come into after which. See, because the concept is building only for the concept of civilization of Aryans.
Yeah. No, actually, they wanted to take over like Shiva. Basically, when one race occupies another race, it's quite natural that the learned, administrator, corporate will be in their hand, and the native will become Shudra or labor, untouchable.
Yes.
So the Indian population were following the Asivagam system, Koil system, where they were actively taking part in administration.
Yes.
After the coming of Aryans, their rights were taken away. So they were not allowed to enter into Koil. Koil means parliament, house of an elected minister.
Okay.
And then later they made it into idol worship, avatar system.
Okay.
So there's two different principles. One is creation and balance, and other is evolution. Aryan sector talks about evolution theory. Das Avatara and all this are evolution theory and mythology.
Yes. Okay.
So we and Shiva is fact, and Vaishnava Varnadharam and all this Kaliya, it's all mythology. Okay. Until today, they are not ready to accept Tamil as a civilized society.
But as per the historical the research is concerned, Tamil is the first thing,
the only civilized race on earth,
civilized the cultivations.
Yeah, and they attribute to alien Anunnaki and all those.
Okay, even for the pyramid concept also Tamil.
There was no other race only, from a single male and female. Bible says that, and Quran
Adam
also
and
Adam and Eve. From that only the genealogy spread.
Okay.
So the story divided is into three parts. Cain, Abel, Seth. Seth is Shiva.
Okay.
And rest is all the followers of Shiva.
So in the world and no other race has been there, and the first race has been initiated by the goddess Tamil race.
Tamil race.
So now after the Tamil race, and because of the first murder taken place by the Cain, so the race has been divided into two, Tamilian and Aryan.
Aryan.
So the cursed race to people is called the comes in by Aryan people.
Aryan, children of Cain. Actually, the word Aryan means noble.
Okay.
That word is also been hijacked by them.
Okay.
that Aryan label should have been given to Tamil people.
okay.
But they tell them that they are Shudra, untouchable, Harijan. All these various levels.
They don't have any concept of civilization.
Yeah.
They don't have a concept of administration skills.
No.
And they have built the civilization concept. So that is called Varnasara Dharma.
Yeah, Varna Ashram. Varna is there. Four profession is already. Without profession, you cannot live. But the rights of administration is taken away from the labor class. No?
Yes.
They were not allowed to enter into Koil. So if you want, we cannot end the profession. We need a learned, administrator, corporate and labor. This is the system.
Yes, this is the system.
We cannot change the system.
Yes.
But we can bring equality between the ruling class and the labor class. How? Through Koil system. We ruling and common people should take an active part in administration.
Okay. So the term, the Koil that you pronounce, the term is?
House of elected minister. King.
Okay. Procedure to electing the king of kingdom.
Kingdom, yeah.
So in earlier it was in Koil, the term is called Koil.
Koil, parliament.
Now it is called the temple.
Yeah, it's not, they have made it into avatar temple.
Okay.
Avatar is not a concept of Shiva.
Okay. So they have completely, they have changed into the simple, the temple is only for the purpose of worship.
Worship, yeah.
But initial stage is the purpose of electing the kingdom.
Kingdom. And plus, see, when God is within us, the Atma is within us, we have to just activate it and connect to higher conscious. For that, you don't need any temple. It's your personal, you can sit in any corner of the of your house and do it.
Okay, and Bible also in saying that. And since you are the temple, you are the church.
Yeah.
So that is the same Bible simple. So all the concept will be abiding with the Bible, Rashal Quran, as well the Asivam
concept.
So now all the Christian dynasty, all the Mahamadian and all other the Veera Vainavam and Shaivam and all the people in Tamilian will be of Tamil race.
Tamil race. No, they will be of Tamil race, and they have to follow Shiva. Because if you don't follow Shiva Koel system, there will be no peace. The ruling and opposition will loot the whole India and the whole world.
They are the Muslim, they have to follow Shiva concept.
Yeah, they have to, because Quran is talking. Na. If they are Muslim, then they should follow Quran.
Okay.
They are not following Jumma system. Na.
Okay.
Jumma is supposed to be behind elected minister.
Okay.
Kingdom, they are following, there is no election system over there. There is no Khalifa system over there. They are just following, blind following their Pujari, Ulamas.
Okay.
And they are giving vague fatwas.
How come the Muslims are accepted and as if now, because they are very rigid in their following system of Mahmudan laws and all that?
See, if you go back in the Bible, the Gentiles are settlers. Jesus Christ clearly says in the Bible, I have come only for the lordship of house of Israel, not for Gentiles. Gentiles are the Aryan settlers.
Okay.
And Bible calls them children of swine.
Okay.
And same thing when Quran chapter 36, 1 to 5. The comforter is nothing but Prophet Muhammad.
Yes.
And the last prophet when he came, the Quran chapter 36, 1 to 11 clearly says that you have been sent to a people whose forefathers were not warned. They had no warner. So they are heedless. If you warn them or you do not warn them, they will not believe. They are stiff-necked.
Aryan and Mongolian.
Yeah.
The two race are the...
No, Aryan settlers, not those people.
Aryan settlers.
Settlers.
Okay, Aryan settlers, that you mean to that who have been cursed people.
The race is cursed. If you see karma concept and DNA concept, they are cursed. But the coming of Antichrist. Coming of Antichrist refers to Roman Empire, Persian Empire, who are now hiding behind the Muslim label.
So Roman...
Roman Empire and Persian Empire. Because Jerusalem is a city of which race? Semitic black.
Yes.
It has been when Jesus said, I have come only for the lordship of house of Israel. Because of Roman Empire, Persian Empire, those children of Israel, they migrated to Arab and Africa. They migrated. Jesus Christ's mission is incomplete. And chapter 17 verse 104 clearly says that end of time, before that is when the Jesus comes, he is going to bring back the children of Israel back to the and take his old Qibla, old administration center Jerusalem, and the new Qibla, that is Makkah, the administration center of Bani Israel, children of Israel, to them.
So now the Mecca is for?
It's for Bani Israel only, but it has been illegally occupied by the Saudis, Aryans.
Aryans. Now, what is the purpose of Mecca, sir?
Makkah is a get-together of a tribals. Like I said, it's a tribal get-together of Semitic blacks.
Okay. So in earlier Mecca was Israel.
No, see the Koel system, administration center, because see, the from Turkey to Indus Valley belongs to Tamilian. But after the defeat of Pandyan kingdom, the first king among the Bani Israel was Saul. As per the Bible and Quran, the first king among the Bani Israel was Saul. And then David came, killed Goliath, and Suleiman built the temple of Suleiman.
Okay.
Because administration, the right.
Okay.
Is with Tamil Shiva genealogy, Sage genealogy.
Okay. And so far, Aryans are trying to defeat the Tamilian civilization.
Tamil
they want
as
to
well
implement
as
their own civilization.
Aryavarta concept is what?
Okay.
Aryavarta means complete domination of Aryan rules on Tamil land.
Tamil.
But since Tamil Nadu is a part of cradle of civilization, and from this land, Cain was cursed and banished. And because of that curse and banish of God, they are not getting entry in Tamil Nadu. Something is happening that they have been stopped. The only thing for them is they are afraid of is Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
Because this is the cradle of civilization. This is Jallikattu. All of a sudden, people have come. It's a Shivite concept, na? Because DNA, because they are, and plus Trikonamala is the real Kailash. LTT, they fought for that Trikonamala, you know. The purpose behind the LTT war was for Trikonamala.
Okay.
So the Trikonamala is the real Kailash of Shiva.
So the Kailash which has been located in the Himalayas, that is not actual
Kailash.
That's a fake. That's a fake Kailash.
Because see, like how Jesus is black, they painted him white.
Okay.
Aryan are cave people.
Okay.
So they painted Shiva as a cave people.
So Shiva is completely black.
He's a black man, so and he's an administrator with a, how administrator lives. He will live that way, na.
Okay. He's the first administrator of Tamilian, and he lives in Tamil land. So that is the Kumarikandam.
Kumarikandam.
So Trikonamala is the Kailash.
Kailash, real Kailash.
So that is the living place of Lord Shiva.
Lord Shiva. Himalaya is a fake Kailash.
Okay.
Because they have portrayed Shiva as their own race.
Okay.
You're getting the point? Because, see, all the religion belongs to Aryans. Holy books belongs to black people.
All right. All right, sir. And thank you so much for the time you're spending with us. And you're giving a lot number of information through your research. And this is completely of new dimension that has been given to our people for understanding of the history and all that. So far we are thinking that three kind of the major ism we have followed by the across the global, and majorly Christianity and Hinduism and Muslim Mugmaran. And now we come to a conclusion that Mugmaran and Christianity both are brothers and sisters.
Yeah.
And they are been taking in one race. And they do have a written document of set of principles.
Yeah.
The all principles that termly called as Asivagam by Lord Shiva. So after which it will be the revolution has been given to Prophet Muhammad, and that has been written in Arabic language.
Yeah.
So that is an Asivagam concept again.
Asivagam, reminding the Asivagam concept.
Asivagam concept.
The Quran clearly says it's a reminder.
All right.
It's not a book of conversion.
Okay, it's a reminder.
It's a reminder.
All right.
And people who don't have anything, like how don't have any books of honor, how can the Quran be their reminder?
So it is not we're talking about for the ism, we're talking about the DNA and race.
Race only.
So and language.
Yeah.
So that is the main thing that we have to follow. That is why we have to understand in future.
Yeah.
So
identify by race and tribe.
All right. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for giving in time and all that.
Thank you.
And this is going to be a great start and great new type of dimension of thinking of people, and this is going to be a very big great success for your future. And as for Tamil Kudiyarasu channel, and we wish you a lot and lot success, and give us a lot more beautiful information, our history. So for our Tamilians, and we do have only for grammatical evidence, we don't have any historical evidence, and latestly we just come to know for Kiradi and all that. And this information are all completely quite different, and we can come to know that how it has been driven out and all that.
See, it's in Kiradi civilization, there is no idol found. That's why in the first 2 years, I think center stopped the funding of excavation. It was a state government who started the excavation, because there was no evidence of their Vedic age.
Yes, yes.
They stopped it.
Yes.
So there's a... The means it's like a stepson. Center is just considering Tamil as a stepson.
All right. So still they're trying to establish their own Aryan
civilization.
They suppress the Tamilian civilization. Okay, all the way, because truth will coming out of one day. So now you are taking care of it, and thank you so much for the part of this show, sir. And sure, we're going to be on the next show. And thank you so much for that.
Thank you.